Hey, it's Clay, and this will be a video chart on ticker symbol ATNM. We will take a look at the 30-minute time frame. If you're new to charts and not sure what I mean by 30-minute, I do offer an explanation video at that link, so you can go there and I'll explain in detail. Well, not to state the obvious on this one, but quite a crazy day, more so a crazy afternoon, because the majority of the day, to offer up a little context here, I mean, the price literally just straight up, just grinded higher and higher, but then the latter part of the day occurred, and I mean, down it went. And it didn't totally destroy the chart, but definitely, you know, shifted the entire landscape of things quite a bit. And the reason why I'm not saying that the entire chart is destroyed, now I realize there's perspective that goes into this, meaning if you're some sort of day trader, scalper, and you bought right there and your plan was to buy and sell within 7 minutes, well then from that point of view, yeah, the chart's looking really, really bad. But assuming you care about more so the bigger picture of things, the reason why I'd still give the benefit of the doubt to the bulls is that the price is still hanging up above 25 cents. And 25 cents is important because, and I'm not saying this will occur, but if the price were to go down to 25, behave like that, and then work its way back upwards, you know, what would you still have emphasis on big picture? Well, from the big picture perspective, you'd still have a set of lows right there. You'd have lows right there. You'd have those lows, and then you'd have even that low down there. If you envision each of those as stair steps, well, then from the big picture point of view, you'd still very clearly have stair steps progressing in the upwards direction. So yeah, not the best with the pullback today. It was a pretty nasty pullback, but looking at more than just one day and looking at multiple days, which we're doing here, you can see the price does still have the opportunity to chip away and build a higher base. So going forward, 25 cents, definitely a very important level, because that's going to help, you know, determine whether or not the price is starting to, you know, continue to chip away at those higher lows, or if the price is starting to look that much shakier because now all of a sudden, you know, the price has entered back into this area of the chart. And not to insult your intelligence, but price movements that go back into areas of the chart, not a sign of strength. You want to see the price making progress. So that's why 25 cents is so important. What about levels of resistance going into next week? First key area to watch, going to be right up there at the 28 cent mark. And I realize the price did go up above there, but when you just look at the amount of kind of, you know, data points, a lot more congestion right around that area. So in my mind, 28 cents is more so kind of that truer level of resistance next week. So an interesting day. I would still call it a bullish day, but yeah, the late afternoon definitely kind of put a little twist on things. So we'll see if this is just a temporary hiccup or if this is the start of something much bigger to the downside, but early next week, certainly going to be interesting. First off, thanks so much for watching the entire video. Real quick, before you go, I want to invite you to a live webinar, web class, training, workshop, online event, whatever you want to call it, but it will be me live revealing to you what I discovered that has allowed me to transform myself from being an employee to being my own boss, including how I had only one losing day out of 73 days in total. I'm going to cover three keys that have helped me unlock profitable consistency within the markets. The first key is super weird, but in a productive type of way. The second key is super awesome because it quite literally is wired into our DNA as humans, making it very easy to use. But in a cruel way, this becomes a pitfall for many traders. I'll explain it all though, including how to avoid the pitfall that it creates for some. And yeah, the third key, when you hear it, sounds way too good to be true, but it's not, and I'll show you how it all works. Then at the end, I open it up for a question and answer session that is, again, totally live. Even if you can't make the live session, please still sign up as it will be recorded, and you can go back and watch the replay that I will send you. Click the image on the screen or click the link down in the description box so you can get the date and time and claim your spot, which I should note is limited due to the fact that this truly is a live event. If you have any questions, let me know. If not, I'll be seeing you soon.